you guys doing up there? You guys are crazy.
Is this Mikey? This is Mikey Plymail right here. Oh, he takes it. King of the mountain. You're watching it here first. Yeah. Troop 1044 live exclusive right here today. And that was Michael, King of the mountain. Then we have Cameron here. Forget it. He's going for it. Whoa. The thing is, though, never say die. You just keep fighting. Dallin takes out Travis. That's an impressive move. Meanwhile, Ethan does a spin move. Fantastic. Yeah. And, all right, I'm just going to come over here and I want to, where's the winner? Where'd he go? Oh, he's down there. Okay. That was Mikey Plymail pretty much took everyone out. He's king of the mountain. He won that round. Give him a high five.
Mikey just sped down. I got dragged.
You were second place, so you were doing it. So come in close, you two. I want to kind of get your... So what's your take on that, Mikey? I mean, was that your first ever King of the Mountain championship?
Yeah.
And what do you say? Yay. What do you say, Cameron? You came in second, although it could have been either one of you. All right. Well, there you heard it first right here. Timber... And then we've got some wild Madden dude running.
All right, this is round two of King of the Mountain. And as you can see, the combatants are arranging themselves here at the top. This one promises to be even a better competition than the prior. We've got a few more heads up there. They're getting all in position right now. Again, they're posturing. They're jockeying here for position. This is no light stuff here. This is like Boston Marathon, right? People trying to make their way out of the chute. So here they are, they're getting set up. Now, we have the human comet, Josh Bauerbank, who is also going to go on this run. We don't know if he's actually going to compete, because his head might have been slightly mashed. So I think he's trying to maybe get that back in better position. It looks like they're talking rules, that's important. Make sure that this is all done according to the rule book.
Ready.
And here it goes, Speed. They're off to the races here. And it looks like Travis did kind of a sneaky move trying to get in there first. But what I see going on here is that Mason is totally blowing the doors off of everybody. Oh, there's a crash and burn up there. I didn't want to catch this. Boom! He gets a little bit of air. Now coming in through second is Daniel. Travis is coming in. Michael. Whoa, Ethan, crash and burn. Human carnage. Dallin Madsen, he's going on through. Cameron decides to save his life. And here is, coming in reverse, is Mitchell Sampson. And then there's Carnage up at the top. There's some people, I can't see if that might be Madden, that died partway. Oh! Again, that was our prior, that's the human comet right there. Doing that trick 360. And pretty much that's the remnants of that run. And he's holding his head. We hope his head isn't mashed. All right, that was... let's see, I'm trying to... I want to interview here the winner of that second round of the TimberLake National, and you saw it here live. So that was Mason Jones. Mason, what do you have to say about that? It was your first ever, I think, winning first place competition in the TimberLake King of the Mountain live extravaganza. So what do you have to say? Yeah? What did you learn from that experience? Anything you could share with posterity and your children and such? As it turns out, it wasn't that big of a deal, but nonetheless, he had fun and we did too. And so that's Kenny, reporter dude, signing off for Troop 1044. Unless, Daniel, you have any senior patrol leader, any closing remarks here on that last run? That was, yeah.
I almost won.
You almost did. You were in second place, and I thought you came through good. You had good energy. I thought you had the eye of the tiger going, and so I just want to give you some props for that. Very well done. Here we have my other camera dude. This is Eric Raymond. What do you have to say about that? Anything that you had?
Oh, man, this is awesome. These guys are just shredding it, tearing it up, going down the hill, being crazy.
You heard
doing
it.
What they do best.
Yeah, they do what they do best. You heard it there. Okay, well, I'm going to sign off on that. And that's Madden doing kind of a, I don't know what that is. It's, I mean, he has his own style, that's for sure. But he, you know, he's in and safe. Madden, anything you have to say about that? About that last run? I mean, like, what happened up there? You were, were you unconscious? Because you were out for a while. I was a little bit worried, but then all of a sudden you popped up and you were running.
I don't remember. Well, I do. Like, I hit my head.
Okay.
And then it kind of just...
So you passed out for a while. That's what you're telling me.
No, I don't know. I think so, but I hit my head, and okay. Then I kind of...
Now, did you have a near-death experience? Was that part of it? Did you float above your body at any point? Nothing like that happened? Okay, good. I'm glad. Well, you saw it there. He hit his head. He was out for a few minutes. We don't know exactly everything that happened, but you saw it. He recovered, and he's now sledding in good form. That's me signing out.
Come on, get some air. Get some air. Come on, Cameron. Okay, Mason, I've got the camera on. Get some air. Oh, crap. Nice. Off to the races. Here they come. Mason's in the lead big time. Go for it, Mason. Go for it. Go for it. Go for it. Woo! Way to go. Whoa, Dallin made it over the...
And then there's carnage up at the top. There's some people, I can't see if that might be Madden.
Guys, look out! Get out of the car!
Soft Detroit. He took the midnight.